Did you know that low cholesterol is actually associated with a higher risk of death? And that what you've been taught about good and bad cholesterol is actually a lie? In this video, I'm gonna do my best to cover everything that you need to know about cholesterol, and I'm gonna give you the scientific evidence to back it up. And before diving into it today, I am in the business of helping you get healthy sustainably and getting rid of all the BS and all the overwhelm and confusing info out there. So if you have not subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and tap that bell. I'm putting new videos out all the time geared to help you get in the best shape of your life. With that said, let's get into it. Hey everybody, my name is Schuyler Diehm. I am a lifestyle fat loss coach. As of recording this video, our fat loss program has helped our clients lose over 2,600 pounds and we've done it sustainably. We make it extraordinarily easy. It is not rare that I hear our clients telling me that this is the easiest and simplest way that they have ever lost weight. So if you want to learn more about our system and potentially grab a complimentary consultation, head down below this video. There's gonna be a link there. It's got a video that shares more of what we do as well as how to book a consultation and see if it's a good fit to work together. So cholesterol, what is it? You've probably heard you've got good cholesterol, you've got bad cholesterol, you want your good cholesterol up, your bad cholesterol down, and if your bad cholesterol is up, you have high cholesterol and that's gonna put you at risk for heart disease. So out of all the confusion out there, one of the most useful resources for me in learning about cholesterol is a book called The Great Cholesterol Myth. It's co-written by Johnny Bowden, Steven Sinatra. Johnny Bowden is actually a certified nutritionist and Steven Sinatra is a cardiologist who's worked with hundreds of patients. So these people know what they're doing. Along with that, if you go to the back of this book, it is literally pages and pages and pages of research studies. So it's not just information that is just pulled out of nowhere or any pseudoscience. You've got studies to back it up. Now, as a fat loss coach who at this point has worked with over 200 people, it is a very common trend where people who are overweight come in concerned with their cholesterol. And the big reason why is that typically what people say is that high cholesterol leads to heart disease. But here is the hypothesis of this book, and it makes an extremely, extremely strong case for it, is that cholesterol is actually not an accurate predictor of heart disease. Now, that may sound crazy, but stick with me. Now, we've all heard that saturated fat is probably the worst for us because it raises cholesterol. Higher cholesterol equals a higher chance of heart disease. Now, there's a lot of different research in this book, but one of the most well-rounded and most impactful studies is called the Lion Diet Heart Study. This study was done with 605 different men and women, and basically what they did is they took people who were prime candidates for heart attacks. These were people that potentially had a heart attack already in the past, that were extremely high stressed, that had a terrible diet, that weren't exercising, that were drinking, that were smoking. Basically, they just weren't taking care of themselves. Half of this group, they put on a Mediterranean diet, which is extremely high in saturated fat. Now, if you've been in the nutrition world, you've heard saturated fat raises your cholesterol. Higher cholesterol leads to heart disease. And then they put the second half of these people on basically your standard American diet. So low fat, low calorie, much more processed foods. Now, here is the crazy part. The people who were on the Mediterranean diet had such a massive reduction in heart disease. It was such a large disparity versus the people who were on the standard American diet that they actually stopped the study early because they thought that it was unethical to continue. In fact, the results of the study found that people on the high-fat Mediterranean diet had a 70% reduction in death and a 76% reduction in cardiovascular deaths. Now here's where it gets really crazy. What they found was that the people in the Mediterranean diet did not have a change to their LDL cholesterol, which is considered the bad cholesterol, or their total cholesterol. So what is cholesterol? Why is it so important? Cholesterol is used in every cell membrane. It helps regulate hormones. It helps your immune system. It helps the production of your testosterone, and it also helps the production of your vitamin D. And what I mentioned at the beginning of this video is that low cholesterol is actually associated with higher death. But the crazy part is that the increase in death actually mostly comes from the psychological side of things. Things that are more mental health related, such as suicide. So cholesterol is necessary. It's necessary for our mental health. It's necessary for our physical health. And so we have to start to identify, okay, what's healthy with a cholesterol level versus what's not. Because yes, if your cholesterol levels are sky high, that's probably not healthy. However, with where it's at, you can also reduce it with very natural changes. And those changes don't involve reducing your red meat intake. In fact, there's lots of evidence that elders with low cholesterol actually have much shorter lives. Now, I want to pull up another study from the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition, and this took a look at 40 separate studies, and it compared them and found that dietary cholesterol was not statistically significantly associated with any coronary artery disease, ischemic stroke, or hemorrhagic stroke. Dietary cholesterol did not statistically significantly change serum triglycerides or very low density lipoprotein concentrations. So, if high cholesterol is not actually an accurate predictor of heart disease, what actually is? So what Johnny Bowden and Steven Sinatra share in this book is that the formula that you are looking for is taking your triglycerides, dividing them by HDL, and looking for a number that's equal to or larger than 2. This means that you can have very high LDL levels of cholesterol, but if your HDL and triglyceride ratio is healthy, you're in a good spot. You're not at risk for heart disease. Now, what things will alter these numbers to actually increase your chance of heart disease? Number 1, inflammation. Number 2, oxidation. Number 3, sugar. And number 4, stress. If you are eating a diet that is high in omega-6 fats, this can be extremely inflammatory. If you aren't exercising, you aren't getting enough rest, these are sources of inflammation too. Oxidation can be created by many other things, including stress, poor diet. Sugar, if you have a high sugar intake, that is going to change your ratio for the worse. And then stress is an extremely, extremely impactful influence as well. Now, I think the coolest thing about this is if you followed me at all, you know a big part of our fat loss program and a big part of my lifestyle is fasting. I'm actually currently almost 3 days into a fast. I'm over 70 hours with no food and I feel fantastic. But the coolest part about this is that fasting actually influences all four of these. Fasting reduces inflammation in the body, it reduces oxidation, it reduces your blood sugar levels, and even though it doesn't directly impact the amount of stress levels that you feel, it does make your cells more resilient to that stress. So if you're not fasting, I highly recommend you get on the fasting train. I've got lots of resources on this page if you don't know where to start, but overall, the major takeaway from this should be the fact that just because they're a doctor or just because they have a formal education, it doesn't mean they know what's best for your body. We are more, quote, advanced than we have ever been, yet at the same time, we have more people dying from heart disease and other disease than ever. In fact, specifically when it comes to statins, which are typically prescribed to lower your cholesterol, there's a lot of evidence in this book that shows that statins are pretty much completely unnecessary unless you are a middle-aged man who suffered a prior heart attack. So 99% of the time, you can drastically increase your lifespan and reduce the chance of you dying from heart disease just by changing your lifestyle, by changing the way that you eat, by moving your body, by sleeping more and improving your stress management, and yes, by fasting as well. So if you have any questions on cholesterol, make sure you head down below this video. I'm here to help you be the happiest, healthiest version of you, so make sure you subscribe. And if you want to tap into my brain directly and you want direct coaching with me one-on-one, make sure you head down below this video to apply for a complimentary consultation. We've helped hundreds of clients and I would love to help you as well. But with that said, thank you so much for watching. And of course, as always, make sure to eat smart, move more, sleep deep, and be grateful for this moment. I'll see you in the next video.